Chelsea's winning run has come to an end at the London Stadium after they drew 0-0 with the Hammers. Watch until the end of the video to get all of my thoughts on the performance, the result and upcoming fixtures. Hello people, welcome to my channel, welcome to another video. This is my video where I'll be giving you my review of the game which took place between West Ham United and Chelsea at the London Stadium in the Premier League, with kickoff being at 1:30pm UK time. So what I'm going to do for you guys in terms of this review is that I'm going to give you the lineup in which Maurizio Sarri put on the pitch to start the game with, and I'll give you my thoughts on the players' performances, then I'll give you my thoughts on the game itself, and then I'll give you my thoughts on how this game has impacted my thoughts on our upcoming fixtures. So without further ado, let's get into the lineup. Maurizio Sarri went with a 4-3-3 with the deep line playmaker involved. I don't even need to say that anymore because we all know what he's going to go with. But in terms of the personnel, I got my lineup prediction correct to the T. I'm not going to brag because I'm not a bragging person. But getting into the personnel, Maurizio Sarri went with Kepa in goal. He went with a back four of Cesar Azpilicueta at right back, a centre-back pairing of David Luiz and Antonio Rudiger, and Marcos Alonso at left back. In terms of the midfield three, he went with Jorginho in that deep-line playmaker role, with Mateo Kovacic and N'Golo Kante just ahead of him. And in the front three, he put Willian in the right-wing position, Eden Hazard in the left-wing position, and Olivier Giroud up front. That's the lineup. So getting into my thoughts on the game, starting off with the first half and then the second half. The first half, I thought both sides started really well. Not many chances to show for it though, for both sides. In terms of Chelsea's passing, I thought that was really good, and the Chelsea team were managing to get around the West Ham players, which was really good. The only problems I do have are that our crossing in the final third was absolutely abysmal, and not many of our passes were in the final third, let alone the bad crosses. So we didn't really have much to show for our dominance in the first 20 to 25 minutes, because in that period we were really good. After that period though, we let West Ham get back into the game and we let them hit us on a few dangerous counter-attacks. And in my opinion, had West Ham had their key players like Marco Arnautovic, Manuel Lanzini and Andy Carroll, we would have conceded in the first half and we would have gone into half-time trailing. The second half though, I did think that we stepped it up a bit, but it wasn't enough for West Ham's solid block in their defensive third. In all honesty, West Ham, they were really good defensively. I thought that they were absolutely solid and they deserved the point, to be honest. In terms of the substitutions, Morata came on for Giroud, and I think that this substitution should have been made at half time because Olivier Giroud was not getting the service and his movement wasn't particularly great, but he had to try and that's what he did. In the 69th minute, Gary Cahill came on for Antonio Rudiger, who is injured. I think he has a groin injury. I need to look into that and I will let you guys know down in the comments section after this review is uploaded. And then Barkley came on for Kovacic in the 79th minute, which I believe is far too late because our midfielders, they were not at it today. They were not at it. And when Barkley came on, he was trying. He put a shot into the box. He put a shot in. He made the keeper stretch. He got a corner from it and he was passing the ball really well when he came on. I think that this substitution should have happened a lot earlier than it did. I think that should have been the first substitution, to be honest. Overall, not the best performance, but not the worst. I do think that West Ham played well. I do think that we do need to improve in all phases of the pitch because we weren't particularly great all around the pitch today. That's my thoughts on the game. Let me know what you think of the game down below. In terms of the result, not a good result at all. Maybe Maurizio Sarri was just telling players to not go full on, because we do have to play Liverpool twice in a row on Wednesday and then on Saturday at Stamford Bridge. But let me know what you think down below, because I'm not entirely sure if that's the case. But please just let me know. Now, to conclude the preview, I am going to give you my thoughts on our upcoming fixtures. Today's performance has just given me absolutely no confidence for the two games we do have to play against Liverpool next Wednesday and next Saturday. Yes, different competitions, so we do not know what Maurizio Sarri is going to do in terms of the lineup, because in all honesty, his decision making in terms of the players today wasn't particularly great. I mean, the substitutions should have come way earlier, some of them should have been at half time. But in terms of the games against Liverpool, if we play the way we did today against West Ham United, Liverpool will spank us and they will destroy us. They will spank us until they leave red marks on our arses. So we have to be careful and we have to tighten up. Maurizio Sarri needs to embrace that as well, because like I said already, his decision making wasn't particularly great today. Yeah, that's all I have to say. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this review. I hope you enjoyed this new style. Yes, I'm beginning to edit again. But yes, come on you Blues, and peace.